A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That was how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean Sea. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. We already see the lowest average speeds of the season here at the Circuit de Monaco, and they'll be even lower in the difficult conditions today. 19 corners make up this famous 2-mile track, and with the rain, it'll be even harder than usual to get that critical heat into the tyres. Don't be surprised if we see a safety car at some point during the Grand Prix. Anthony Davidson joins me again for the race today. Let's talk briefly about Sebastian Vettel. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position today, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Bottas, Sebastian Vettel, and Raikkonen, Sainz, Grosjean, Leclerc, and Nico Hülkenberg, Magnussen, Ericsson, Stoffel Van Dorn, and Hartley, Perez. They've taken a grid penalty. Gasly, Lance Stroll, and Esteban Ocon, Alonso, and a Williams rounds off the grid. And now...
Running now, no heroics is discernible, please. We're in amongst the pack and just need to stay in one piece.
Firmou velká cena Monaka vozu Formule 1, do kterého odstartuji z posledního místa. Vůbec se mi tady nedařilo. V každém tréninku i v kvalifikaci jsem byl poslední. Proto jsem se taky rozhodl absolvovat také
illegal maneuver, cede that position or receive a penalty. You've got front wing damage, recommend you box for a new one. Okay, box, box, box. We're adjusting the strategy. Come in this lap.
Penalizaci. opportunity to fall into the deck, limit the rolls and attack. Mě se mi už převodovku na nic.
Let's turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy.
Energy system.
Bahrain about 2 minutes away. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
Thank you.
Ναι.
Are you all right? Engine off, engine off.
Výrazně méně.
Problem s audem.
Sebastian Vettel.
Let me know you're all right.
That's a bit of a problem, wasn't it?
Let's turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy.
A net effect.
It's a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
Okay, action.
Blue flag. We're not racing the car behind. Let them pass when you can. What happened? Let me know you're okay. it's time to use some of this charge. Be careful with the front wing, you've taken some minor damage. Check your MFD for it. radar's showing a clear patch on its way. There's about 10 more minutes of this rain. Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace.
Thank you.
ty się naseru jak jeźdźce.
I don't think the line is really dry enough yet to start the winking mass next to the top of the entrance. Two laps of fuel remaining.
The Red Bull team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly well-deserved win. So, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, keeping their tyre temperatures up in the tricky wet conditions was really important. There's not much grip out there at the best of times, so it's 10 times worse if you're out there on cold tyres. So the way they kept the rubber in its proper operating window was a huge advantage today.
And I can see now the drivers are making their way out. We need Red Bull fighting at the front. They do an incredible amount for Formula One. And that's another winner's trophy heading back to Milton Keynes. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. It's a good result for Kimi Raikkonen, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Kevin Magnussen. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And here's how things are shaping up at the Constructors' Championship. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. Meanwhile, good work from Force India this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Hamilton, masový titul v Brazílii. Tady má blokka. 14. Aldo Trumetrika, 100. Panda, 15. Brandon Hartley, 16. Lance Stroll, 18. Esteban Ocon, 5-7 penalizace. Takže Ericsson, Alonso, Ocon, Magnussen. Bez zastávky v boxech, Pierre Gasly a já. Dvě zastávky v boxech a jediný, který nedají, je Carlos Sainz. Ale ne. Jak se mělo podívat, Kimi Räikkönen zvýšil náskok na 12 bodů před Lewisem Hamiltonem. Naštěstí jste se posunul s Sebastianem před Valtteri Bottasem, Red Bull si pohodili pozice. Nico Hülkenberg zůstal na 7. místě. Kevin Magnussen 12 bodů šel v David Carson Sainze a má stejný podíl jako Nico Hülkenberg. 10. tedy Romain Grosjean, oba body za ním Fernando Alonso, Charles Leclerc, jeho první letošní body za 7. místo. Zrůl to i před svého týmu jeho kolegu Marcusa Ericssona, který dojel 14. 14. Stoffel van Dorn, který dojel 14. Spadl na 13. místo. 14. se bude van Dorn, se říkal. 15. Tý jsem já. Stoffel na 16. místě a 18. místa dál, čili Esteban Ocon, Brandon Hartley, Lentro a Pierre Gasly. Gasly díky zestupu Charlesa Leclerca, Lentro a Pierre Gasly možná bez budu. A Fersdina se posunula před Williams o jeden bod, pak o jeden bod za námi Toro Rosso, tým se dvou týmů bez změny. Uf, díky bohu, že už je to za mnou. To byla hrůza.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy.
Sure.
How do you feel the weather affected the outcome today? Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash?
Takže nás to je zavěšení přítlaka.
It must be gutting to miss out on a podium due to penalties. Do you think it was the right call by the officials?
Jako, můžu si zvolit jenom, že je to ostuda nebo to rozhodnutí. A zase se snížil reputaci Williamsu.
Great! Well, that's everything.
Ach, jo. Já už jsem zvolil na kaplík! Sice se za další 20 dílů vrátím. Lenzo mě teďka výrazně dotáhl, ale já teďka můžu na zemtí kolik zdraje v Kanadě. Může se tím nasrat spolehlivost. FK 14 nebo lepší, to jsem mi provedl minule ve Španělsku. Ale všude. Z mý komerce jsou mi lesná reputace.
You hit your last team goal. Well done. That should get the team a nice boost to their development. And it won't hurt when it comes to your next contract review either.
Morálka u spolehlivosti je nízká. Zvýšení ceny o 4%. Myslím si, že už můžu dělat. Zadat si. Jsi na 50, protože jsem je v médiích nasral. Už je to jen 276 bodů. A já se s váma loučím, děkuji, že jste se dívali a zatím nasledanou. Už já už si ty dumb like a bitch.